Let y of t represent your bank account balance in dollars after 2 years. Suppose you start with $80,000 in the account. Each year the account earns 8% interest and you deposit $4,000. This can be modeled using the differential equation given here. Also notice that y of 0, the starting account balance is $80,000. We're asked to solve for y of t. So we'll begin by determining the general solution to this differential equation using separation of variables, and then we'll find the particular solution using this initial condition. So for the first step, we'll multiply both sides of the equation by dt, which would give us dy equals the quantity 0.08y plus 4,000 times dt. But because we have the dy on the left side, we want this expression here also on the left side because it contains y. So now we'll divide both sides by this quantity. This simplifies to 1. Let's write the left side as 1 divided by the quantity 0.08y plus 4,000 dy equals dt, or if we want 1 dt. And now we can integrate both sides of this equation and then solve for y. Let's do this on the next slide. To integrate the left side with respect to y, we'll have to perform a u substitution where the denominator is going to be u. So we have u equals 0.08y plus 4,000. Therefore, differential u is equal to 0.08 dy. So if we solve this for dy by dividing both sides by 0.08, we have du divided by 0.08 equals dy. So if we write the left side in terms of u, we'd have this extra factor of 0.08 in the denominator. So we could write this as 1 divided by 0.08 times the integral of 1 over u du. And the integral of 1 over u is just natural log u, which is really natural log of the absolute value of 0.08y plus 4,000, but then this is divided by 0.08. We would have plus c here, but we'll also have plus c on the right side, so we'll just include it on the right side. So on the right we have the integral of dt, or if we want 1 dt, which would just be t, and then plus we'll call it c sub 1. The next step, let's go ahead and isolate this natural logarithm by multiplying both sides by 0.08. So we'd have the natural log of the absolute value of 0.08y plus 4,000 equals 0.08t. But then instead of writing 0.08 times c sub 1, let's let c equal 0.08 times c sub 1, so we can just write plus c. And now to solve for y, we can write this log equation as an exponential equation. Notice how we'd have e raised to this power here must equal this quantity here. Or we can also just exponentiate both sides of the equation. Let's go ahead and do that. E to the power of this quantity must equal e to the power of this quantity. So notice how the left side simplifies nicely to the absolute value of 0.08y plus 4,000. But because on the right side we have e raised to a power, which will always be positive, we can drop the absolute value. So we would just have 0.08y plus 4,000 equals, and on the right side, because we have a sum in the exponent, we can write this as e raised to the power of 0.08t times e to the c. But if c is a constant, e to the c is also a constant, so if we let a equal e to the power of c, we can rewrite this as 0.08y plus 4,000 equals a times e to the power of 0.08t. And now to solve for y, we'll subtract 4,000 on both sides. That would give us 0.08y equals a times e to the 0.08t minus 4,000. And now for the last step, we'll divide both sides by 0.08, giving us y, or y of t, equals a times e raised to the power of 0.08t minus 4,000 divided by 0.08. So now we're making some progress. This would be the general solution to the given differential equation, but because we were also given that y of 0 equals 80,000, we can now find the particular solution by using the initial condition to find this constant a. Let's go ahead and do this on the next slide. So now if we know that y of 0 equals 80,000, that means when t equals 0, this function value must be 80,000. So to find a, we'd have the equation 80,000 equals a times e to the power of, well, if t is 0, the exponent would be 0, e to the 0 is equal to 1, minus 4,000 divided by 0.08. So to begin solving this equation for a, we'll multiply both sides of the equation by 0.08. So this product here is 6,400. On the right side, this simplifies to 1. And again, e to the 0 is equal to 1, so we have a minus 4,000. Adding 4,000 to both sides, we have a equals 10,400. And now that we know the value of a is 10,400, we have our solution, y of t. Y of t is equal to 10,400 times e raised to the power of 0.08t minus 4,000 divided by 0.08. We could write the decimal as a fraction and change the form of this function, but I think we'll go ahead and leave it in this form here. I hope you found this explanation helpful.